Before we start to learn various operators in Java, I want to cover a topic which confuses most of the newcomers in Java. This confusion occurs when you use byte or short variables in an operation. Hello everyone, I am Gyan and you are watching the second session of Java and Web, variables, data types and operators. Let's see these two examples below. In these two examples, everything is okay. In this program, we are storing the constant 5 in the byte variable b and then after we are printing the variable b. Output is 5. And in this program, we are storing the constant 5 in the byte variable b1. Then after we are storing the byte variable b1 in the byte variable b. And finally, we are printing the byte variable b. Output is 5. Let's execute these programs. Open the file confusion.java. Here we are storing the constant 5 in the byte variable b. And then we are printing the byte variable b. It should work. Save it and compile it. Java C confusion.java. Compiles fine, then run it. Java confusion. It runs fine. Then after let's make a change. Right here byte B1 is equal to 5. And below this line, right here byte B is equal to B1. And then print B. See what's happening here. Compiles fine and then executes fine. So everything is okay in these examples. We have again two examples here. The first example is similar to previous one. We are storing the constant 5 in the byte variable b, then we are printing the byte variable b. But here we are storing the constant 5 in the integer variable I and then we are storing the integer variable I in the byte variable b. In this case, compiler throws an error and the code does not compile. Now my doubt is, if by default a whole number literal is 32-bit integer constant, then what is the difference between storing an integer literal and storing an integer variable? I want to say that as we know, an integer literal by default is 32-bit integer constant. So writing 5 here itself is a 32-bit integer constant and in the range of the byte. Here we have integer variable I, which we are going to store in the variable of type byte. So what is the difference between two? This one is integer literal and this one is integer variable. Both are integers and both are in the range of the byte. So why we can store the integer constant in the byte variable b and why we cannot store the integer variable in the byte variable b if both are in the range of the byte? Let's see the cause behind the above error. We have a byte variable b. We are storing the constant 5 in it. As we already know that the integer constant is by default a 32-bit integer. The constant is by default 32-bit integer constant. Since 5 is in the range of minus 128 to 127 and since a constant is used in the right hand side, not variable, 5 is a constant, not variable, compiler does implicit narrowing in this case and converts the 32-bit 5 in the 8-bit 5, successfully stores 5 in the variable b. But the scenario is little different when we are going to store a variable instead of constant in the byte variable b. Here we are storing the variable I in the byte variable b. I is the 32-bit integer variable. It's a 32-bit integer variable. Even if the value of the variable I is 5 in the range of the minus 128 to 127, but since a variable is used in the right hand side, compiler does not do implicit narrowing and results an error. Here we need explicit narrowing. Narrowing means to cut down whatever at the right hand side so that it can be accommodated in the variable at left hand side. If we are using a constant at the right hand side, then at the compile time, compilers knows that what is the range of the constant at the right hand side. But if we are using the variable at right hand side, the compiler at compile time cannot guess what is being stored in the given variable at right hand side. When we assign an in-range integer constant in a byte variable or short variable, of course, a whole number constant is of 32 bits, but it gets narrowed down by the compiler itself to 8 or 16 bits according to the variable if it is byte or short. If the constant is in the range of the corresponding byte or short, then the compiler automatically narrow down an assigning constant or variable, then this is called the implicit narrowing. Implicit narrowing occurs only for the integer constants. But the same is not true when we are assigning an integer variable in byte or short variables. In this case, we need to do explicit narrowing. We will learn explicit narrowing in the later video of this session named Typecasting of the Primitive Variables in Java. If we have a byte variable named b1, we are storing 5 in this byte variable, and we have other byte variable b, and we are storing the b1 in the byte variable b. At the compile time, compiler knows that it is a byte. So compiler does not throw any error. Since b1 is the byte, so there is no problem if we store it in a byte variable b. By now, we have understood about how compiler does implicit narrowing when we are assigning a variable or constant to a byte or sort variable. But the situation is more confusing when you are doing a binary operation on the byte or sort variables. Here we are adding two constants, 5 plus 6, and storing it in byte. And then we are printing the byte variable b. It outputs 11. Everything is okay. But here we are storing the constant 5 in the byte variable b1. And then we are adding b1 plus 6 to store it in the byte variable b. Then it throws an error. Means if we are using an integer constant, then it's okay. But if we are using a byte variable to store it in byte, then it's an error. Let's see this practically. Vi add.java. Here we are adding 5 and 6 to store it in a byte variable b, and then we are printing the byte variable b. Compile and execute it. Java c add.java. Compiles fine, then run java class name add. Runs fine and prints 11. Now let's modify add.java. Right here, byte b1 is equal to byte b1 is equal to 5, and then write here b1. Now instead of writing 5, we are using byte variable b1. Try to compile it. Java c add.java compiles fine. Compiler throws an error saying incompatible types, possible lossy conversion from int to byte. It may look funny for the newcomer. When you use constant 5, which is a by default 32-bit integer literal, it results fine. But when you use byte variable to store it in byte, then it is throwing an error and saying that possible lossy conversion from integer to byte. Means why this error was not occurred when we were using 5 instead of b1. The story does not end here. Let's update the program and write here byte b2 is equal to 6. Byte b2 is equal to 6, and then write here byte b is equal to b1 plus b2. Now both the operands in this operation are bytes, and we are storing this result in the byte. Let's compile it and see what the compiler is saying. Java c add.java. Compiler again says possible lossy conversion from int to byte. Means where is int, man? Both are byte variables. We are adding these byte variables to store in the third byte variable. Where is int? When I am using integer constants, then you are saying it's okay. You are storing it in the byte variable. But when I am using byte variables, you are saying that it's possible lossy conversion from int to byte. Where is int? When I was using the int, you didn't throw that error. And when I am using the byte, you are throwing this error. So the newcomers may have this type of confusion. This is the case when we are adding two bytes to store in the third bytes, and compiler throws the error, saying that possible lossy conversion from integer to byte. Now let's understand the concept behind it. This concept is going to work on the all binary operations you are going to study in this session. So please give her special attention now. You have a byte variable b, where you are storing the summation of constant 5 and constant 6. Constant 5 is already by default 32-bit integer, and constant 6 is also by default 32-bit integer. Both are 32-bit integers. Their summation results in a 32-bit integer, that is 11. Since the result 11 is in the range of minus 128 to 127, and since no variable is used in the operation, compiler does implicit narrowing and converts 32-bit 11 in the 8-bit 11, successfully stores 11 in the byte variable b. Since no variable is used here, so compiler at the compile time knows about the result. Compiler knows that the result is going to be 11, and that can be accommodated in the byte variable. Now see this example. We have byte b1 is equal to 5. We have the other byte variable b, in which we are storing the result of b1 plus 6. Here the compiler does not know what is going to be stored by the byte variable b1. If it was 125, then adding 6 will go beyond the range of the byte. So compiler throws an error when you are using a byte variable, because at the compile time, compiler does not know about the value of a variable. So compiler thinks that after addition, it may go beyond the range of byte. That's why compiler throws an error. But the story does not end here. At the time of execution, all the variables and constants gets converted to the biggest data type in the operation. And here since 6 is by default an integer literal, so B1 first gets converted to 32-bit integer. So both are 32-bit integers now, and their result is also 32-bit integers, that is 11. Even if the result 11 is in the range of minus 128 to 127, but since at least one variable is used in the operation, compiler does not do implicit narrowing and results error. Here we need explicit narrowing. Let's see some other example. We have the byte variable B, in which we are adding the result of the summation of character literal A and the integer literal 6. Since the biggest data type in the operation is integer, 6 is by default a 32-bit integer literal. So the Unicode of A first gets converted to 32-bit integer. 6 is already by default 32-bit integer. So both are now 32-bit integers, and their result is also 32-bit integer, which is 71. Since the result 71 is in the range of minus 128 to 127, and since no variables is used in the operation, this is a character constant and this is an integer constant, compiler does implicit narrowing and converts 32-bit 71 in 8-bit 71, successfully stores 71 in the byte variable B. Now we have a character variable CH which stores the character literal capital A. We have a byte variable B, and we are storing the result of summation of variable CH plus 6 in the byte variable B. Biggest data type in this operation is 6, because 6 is by default a 32-bit integer literal. So CH variable first converted into the 32-bit int. 6 is already by default 32-bit integer. So both are 32-bit integers, and their result is going to be a 32-bit integer, which is 71. But even if the result 71 is in the range of minus 128 to 127, but since at least one variable is used in the operation, compiler does not do implicit narrowing and results error. Here we need explicit narrowing. Let's see other example. We have two byte variables, B1 and B2. B1 storing 5 and B2 storing 6. Then after we have a byte variable B, in which the summation of B1 and B2 is going to be stored. Look at here, in this operation, both operands are bytes. Even if the biggest data type in this operation is byte, you have to remember one more rule. If the biggest data type in the operation is a byte or sort, then the all variables in that operation gets converted to integer, and result of that operation is also integer. That's why here byte B1 gets converted to 32-bit integer, and byte B2 also gets converted to 32-bit integer. So remember that even if the biggest data type is byte or sort, then all the operands gets converted into the integer data type, 32-bit integer data type, and it results the 32-bit integer data type. So both are 32-bit integer now, and the result 11 is also 32-bit integer. Look at here, even if the result 11 is in the range of minus 128 to 127, but since at least one variable is used in the operation, here two variables are used, compiler does not do implicit narrowing and results error. Here we need to do explicit narrowing, because both the operands and the result itself gets converted to integer. Let's see another example. We have the byte variable B1 is equal to 5, and we have the float variable F, which is going to store the result of the operation B1 plus 6.2F. So we are adding the float constant 6.2 to the byte variable B1. Since the biggest data type in the operation is a float, so byte variable B1 gets converted into float, and the 6.2 is already a floating point literal. So both are now floats, and the result of this summation is also float, which is 11.2. Compiler does not do implicit narrowing, but the variable F can be stored in the float data type, so no error. Implicit narrowing only occurs if the operands are integer constants. Let's execute this example, vi add.java, and here we are storing the result of summation of byte variable and the float constant in the float variable F, and then we are printing the float variable F. Compile and execute it, java c add.java, compiles fine, and then run it, java add, and it runs fine, printing 11.2. Let's see another example. We have the byte variable b1 is equal to 5, and we have a float F. In the float F, we are storing B1 plus 6.2. Here the biggest data type in the operation is a double, which is 6.2. Because the fractional literal 6.2 is by default a double. That's why B1 first gets converted into double. 6.2 by default is a double data type. So both are now double data types. And their result is also the double data type, which is 11.2. Now we are trying to store a double data type in the variable of type float, which results an error. Compiler results an error because the final result of the type double cannot be stored in the float variable. Let us try this example, vi add.java, And write here 6.2 instead of 6.2f. Make it double literal. Now compile it and see what the compiler is saying. Java CI.java. Compiler says incompatible types, possible lossy conversion from double to float. The result of this operation is double, which is going to be stored in the variable of type float. Let's look at some more examples. We have float variable f, in which we are storing the summation of a float literal and a double literal. So first, the 5f gets converted to double data type, and result of this operation is a double data type, 11.2. The double data type cannot be stored in the float variable f. That's why compiler results error, because the final result of the type double cannot be stored in the float variable. This is the abstract of whatever you studied in this video. Pause this video and note it down. That's all for this video, guys. Don't forget to like and share this video. Subscribe this channel if you are new, and leave your valuable comments in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.